We say, Our Father, who art in heaven. We call God our Father, not because God is an old man in the sky, but because God maintains a relationship with God's children. God is personal, beyond the human understanding of gender, and yet always close to us, like a mother who will not forsake her nursing child, like a father who runs to welcome the prodigal home. This is the transcendent God in whom we put our faith.
Thank you.
and it is right to lift our hearts and give our thanks and praise to the God who works.
Thank you.
God's kingdom to come expecting a conquering Lord. But God's will is instead embodied by a teacher and healer who was unjustly condemned for blasphemy and sedition. Jesus was crucified, suffering the depths of human pain, and gave his life for the sins of the world. God raised Jesus from the dead, vindicating his sinless life, breaking the power of sin and evil, delivering us from death to life.
Thank you.
trespasses, sins, each an acceptable way to pray today. God, who steadfastly forgives when we rebel against God. When we hide from our Creator, we deserve God's condemnation. Yet God acts with justice and mercy to redeem creation. Whether we owe something, have violated each other's boundaries, or missed the mark, God forgives us out of everlasting love.
Amen.
often touched by darkness. God's path leads us through those waters and into the promised land on the other side.
Thank you.
rejoice that nothing in life or in death can separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
Thank you.
Amen. What a beautiful and inspiring proclamation. Again, I want to remind everyone that you're all welcome to join us in Hefner Hall for a reception. And may the love of our risen Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the grace of God our Creator, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all, now and forevermore.